Hey everyone, it's Darren here. I'm gonna do something a little different. I'm gonna do a video response, which I've never done, to Scott Waters, who did a video response to a guy named Farley. I'm not familiar with him. I'm gonna check him out later. But anyways, Farley did a top five thrash metal bands of the 1980s debut albums, and he left out the top, like the big four: Anthrax, Slayer, Metallica, and Megadeth. Scott included, Farley, his top five was Zentrix, Metal Church, Testament, Overkill, and Death Angel. So I'm going to leave those ones alone. I'm going to leave the top four alone. Scott did Faith or Fear, which I have on vinyl. Hallows Eve, which I don't have anything by. Annihilator, Alice in Hell, which I have on vinyl. Believer. Extractions of Mortality, which I have on disc. Flotsam and Jetsam, the first one. Doomsday for the Deceiver, which I have on vinyl, box set, and regular CD as well. And he did Vengeance Rising, which was his top. So I'm going to do mine. I, like Scott, narrowed it down to six. One's on CD because I don't have that on vinyl yet, but I will. And the other five are on vinyl. Now, mine are early thrash. So I left all Scott's alone, all Farley's alone, and the top four alone. This is my list for top six debuts of the 1980s thrash movement. Okay, number one, Razor Executioner's Song. This by far is pure thrash. It's fast, it's loud, great vocals, it's amazing. Best song on here, Take This Torch, by far, hands down, probably my favorite, one of, if not my most favorite Razor track. Violent Restitution being my favorite Razor album, but Take This Torch off this album, bar none, best track ever. And this isn't in any particular order either. The next one up is, I have this original pressing right from, and by the way, this came out in, can't remember, 84, I believe. This one, Forbidden Evil by Forbidden. This came out in 1988. This is the debut. What's to say? Chalice of Blood, probably the best song on here. Feel No Pain, As Good as Dead, Follow Me, Forbidden Evil, just awesome stuff. Like, these guys were like right in from the, if I remember correctly, these guys were San Francisco, I believe. They weren't LA. I think they were San Francisco thrash. But yeah, this one again, I mean, I've had this since it came out, which was 1988. So I was 18 when I bought it. This one is a conglomerate of two bands. But this is their debut, came out 1985. This is a reissue. SOD, Speak English or Die. I remember when I first got this on tape. I don't know how many times. I don't even think I have the tape anymore. I have this on disc and I have this on vinyl. This is a reissue on splatter vinyl. Megaforce Records, this one came out in 2008, but originally came out in 85. So, yeah, just great stuff. Great stuff. Now, this band, this is one of my favorite albums from the 80s, I think. I just love this album. I had a friend of mine, he dubbed it for me on tape. This is how far back it goes. This one is from 1988. Again, Violence, Eternal Nightmare. Now, this band was the catalyst for Machine Head. As we all know, Rob Flynn and Phil Demmel, they are in Machine Head. Rob Flynn started Machine Head back in, well, when this band dissolved, or when he left this band, I'm going to say early 90s, 92, I think. I think 94, their first album came out, Burn My Eyes. Great, another great debut from the 90s. So if we'll get around to doing the 90s thrash, that one probably will most likely be number one. But yeah, Eternal Nightmare from Violence. This album is just, it's chaotic, it's fast, it's loud, it's heavy. Totally friggin' awesome. Next one up, another Canadian band. Of course, I have to have Canadian bands, being a Canadian boy. Although I like their next album after this one more. Exciter, Heavy Metal Maniac. This came out in 1983. And these guys have been around since 1978. The original band is now back together. I think it's the original band. Yeah, it is the original band. With Dan Beeler, John Rickey, and Alan Johnson. I don't know if they're putting an album out, but I know they're touring. They did a bunch of dates. Best song on this album is Cry of the Banshee. It's awesome. This is on a splattered vinyl as well. My wife bought me this album, actually. We were walking through one of the record stores, and I spotted it. It's a limited edition, 419 of 500. You can get it in there. See? Yeah. Great, great album. I mean, Exciter. Who doesn't know Exciter? If you're not, and a lot of people will argue the point. Some people will call them speed metal. They're a thrash metal band, as far as I'm concerned. I think even the band, in earlier videos, they call themselves more of a power metal band. I don't know. You can split hairs all day long. I think they're a thrash metal band. They were loud. They were fast. A lot of hooks. A lot of fast songs. Singing drummer. I mean, come on. Yeah. Just, I mean, what else can you say about it? And my last but not least, probably the second favorite album from this band. First one being Pleasure to Kill. Creator. Endless Pain. This one is on Blood Red Vinyl. I got this. This one came out in 85. This might not even be the first pressing. This one came out in 85. This isn't a repressing or anything. I think I bought it a couple years later. This is on the SPV label, I believe. Let me take a look. This album is in mint condition, and I've had this since, yeah, it's SPV label. Noise Records, SPV. See? I've had this forever and a day. This is one of those albums I would never give up. So if anybody's inquiring, no, don't bother. This is actually a German import. The cover, look at, still glossy. And this album is, you know, 32 years old already. And it's in immaculate shape. Corners aren't even, still sharp corners, still just everything. I bought this back in, I had to have been 19 because I was with, hanging around with a bunch of guys that were still from my youth, and I paid 15, 16 bucks for it back then, and it came as an import. So, yeah. So anyways, I don't have any honorable mentions. I mean, there's so many bands out there that you can include in this list. I mean, Vengeance Rising, great innovators of, you know, Christian thrash metal. Believer for sure. Even Deliverance, their first album was a speed thrash record. I don't know, early Tourniquet, if you want to call them a thrash metal band. Just there's just so much. Heathen, Dark Angel, All the Way. I mean, all these bands were great. I didn't want to mention any of those. These ones I wanted to keep. I have Dark Angel, Darkness Descends. I have all the Dark Angel on vinyl. Great, great band. I can go on for days. I mean, about all these bands. Anyways, but I figured I'd grab these ones, and then whatever I don't grab, hopefully somebody else will see my video, and they'll go to Scott's video, and then the Farley's video, then they'll watch all of them, and then they'll put out theirs. Top 5, but I'd go for top 6. Peace out, guys. See you next video.